Hello students, in the last lecture we have learned graphical representation for first order reaction, zero order reaction. Then we have done integrated rate law equation for zero order reaction, first order reaction, the equation to determine half life for zero order and first order reaction. We did some numericals based on that. Now for the today's class we are going to start with temperature dependence of reaction rates. That is, how is the rate of reaction dependent on the temperature? Now, a mathematical relationship between energy of activation, rate constant, and temperature is been established by Arrhenius, which is called as Arrhenius equation. Arrhenius equation suggested that the rate of reaction varies with temperature as below. That is, K is equals to A into e raised to the power minus Ea upon RT. We say this as Arrhenius equation. This is one form of Arrhenius equation, which is explaining us the correlation between reaction rate, that is rate constant, pre-exponential factor, activation energy, and temperature. So in this given expression, as I just mentioned, K stands for our rate constant, Ea stands for our activation energy, R is our molar gas constant, T is temperature in Kelvin, that is absolute temperature, and A is called pre-exponential factor. Now, in this, what do we stand for, or what do we mean by Ea, that is activation energy? It is an energy required to form an activated complex or transition state from the reactant molecules. As I mentioned below, or as I mentioned before, whenever a reaction proceeds to give us product, before forming a product, it forms an intermediate, which we call it as transition state. So, as to reach the transition state, whatever is the minimum energy required, that minimum energy is called activation energy, or also called as energy of activation. Now, what about the second term called as pre-exponential factor, or it is also called as frequency factor. Frequency factor of pre-exponential factor is the one which is proportional to the frequency of collisions between the reactant molecules, because for the reaction to proceed, the very important point is the collisions to take place between the reactant molecules, and its frequency is measured in terms of pre-exponential factor, or also called as frequency factor. Now in this given equations, the units which we need to write, our T, as it is absolute temperature, it will be in Kelvin. Frequency factor or pre-exponential factor A, its unit will be same as that of rate constant, especially when the reaction is of first order. Then the unit of Ea, that is activation energy, and the unit of molar gas constant need to be same, which will be generally in terms of joules per Kelvin per mole, or it will be in terms of kilojoules per Kelvin per mole. So this is one form of our Arrhenius equation, which gives a relationship of rate depending on its temperature. The next part is graphical representation. For that we make use of our Arrhenius equation. That is, K is equals to A into e raised to the power minus Ea upon RT. To this given equation, we take logarithm on both the sides. So give us ln of K is equals to minus Ea upon RT plus ln of A. That is nothing but our natural base. If we convert our natural base to base 10, then this given equation can be rewritten as log to the base 10 of K is equals to minus Ea upon 2.303 RT plus log to the base 10 of A. This is another form of equation for Arrhenius. Based on this, we correlate it with our straight line equation, that is y is equals to mx plus c. On correlation, we get our y axis as log to the base 10 of k, x axis as 1 by t, giving us, following our straight line equation, intercept value and the slope value. Now if you could relate k and 1 by t, it is inversely proportional. So the nature of the plot will be declining, that is it is inversely proportional. So log to the base 10 of k versus 1 by t will give a plot which is declining, having an intercept value. The intercept value will be on y axis, giving us the value for log to the base 10 of a, and the slope will be a negative slope because it is declining, giving us a value minus ea upon 2.303 r. So this is our graphical representation based on Arrhenius equation. Again, the question can be asked is the nature of the graph. So remember, the graph nature will be declining with a negative slope and a y-intercept. The next part we come is the application of Arrhenius equation. The very important application of Arrhenius equation is it helps us to determine activation energy, which we are going to see how. Determination of activation energy can also be said as a relation showing variation in rate constant with temperature. For both of this, the derivation is going to be same. For that, we will again make use of our Arrhenius equation. Log to the base 10 of k is equals to log to the base 10 of a minus ea upon 2.303 rt, where, as I mentioned, k is our rate constant, a is our pre-exponential factor or frequency factor, ea is activation energy, r is molar gas constant, and t is absolute temperature. Now, for two different temperatures, T1 and T2. For temperature T1, the above equation can be written as log to the base 10 of K1 is equals to log to the base 10 of A minus ea upon 2.303 r T1. For temperature T2, the equation can be written as log to the base 10 of K2 equals to log to the base 10 of A minus ea upon 2.303 r T2. So at two different temperatures, you can see the rate constant varies. As the reaction is same, the pre-exponential factor will be same. So in this given two equations, which we write it as equation 1 and equation 2, K1 is our rate constant at temperature T1 and K2 is rate constant at temperature T2. We subtract equation 1 from equation 2. Now, why is this? Reason behind, in this, our T1 temperature is less than T2. Temperature and rate are directly proportional. So definitely lower the temperature, lower will be the rate constant value. And that is why we subtract our equation 1 from equation 2 and not the other way round. So on subtracting equation 1 from equation 2, we get log to the base 10 of K2 minus log to the base 10 of K1. Pre-exponential factor being same gets cancelled. Minus ea upon 2.303 r 1 upon T2, minus of minus becomes plus, ea upon 2.303 r 1 upon T1. So if we rearrange this given equation, we get log to the base 10 of K2 upon K1 is equals to ea upon 2.303 r in bracket 1 upon T1 minus 1 upon T2. This given equation can be rewritten as log to the base 10 of K2 upon K1 is equal to ea upon 2.303 r into bracket T2 minus T1 upon T1 T2. Remember, our T2 is higher temperature and T1 is lower temperature, and that is why we get T2 minus T1. So this is the given equation which gives us a relationship of variation of rate constant with temperature, and this can also help us to determine the activation energy of the given reaction.